Welcome back, guys. Just a quick tutorial today on before updating the firmware on your ColdCard or any Bitcoin software for that matter. It's always very good practice to verify the integrity of the firmware before running the update. And I'm going to show you how to do this with the genius of Craig Raw, the founder of Sparrow Wallet. I'm going to show you how to do this quickly and without running code or getting too technical. Let's jump in. So I haven't used my ColdCard in a while, and I noticed that there is a new firmware update, which was issued on, I think, the 26th of June by CoinKite. And I thought, what a good opportunity to just show you how to use this verification code within Sparrow. Because what we want to do is you always want to verify the firmware before running it. And we want to check confirm the hash of the SHA-256. Verify the signatures of the devs and make sure that the firmware is legitimate and not malicious. Okay, so if you want to sleep better at night, I suggest you take this extra step because it will give you peace of mind and reassure you that you are running 100% the correct software from CoinKite. And I'll show you how to do this. It's always a good idea to make sure you're running the latest version of the firmware that is available. And to get started, guys, we're just going to go to coldcard.com. And then go into documents, and we are gonna see what is the latest firmware available. Just click into there. Okay, so at the top of the page, we can see that the current version is I'm using the Mark IV, the MK4, and the latest version is a 5.3.3, which was released yesterday. So, okay, I definitely don't have this version, so perfect opportunity to do this. So I'll walk you through the process of how to do the verification. So just some prerequisites of what we're going to need to do this. We will obviously need our ColdCard, MK4, I have here. I'm going to be powering that with my USB Hyperjuice. Okay. And we're going to need a card reader, and we're going to need a MicroSD card. This is a macro. It's just, I keep it in there so I don't lose the thing. Okay, so we're going to load this up, and what we'll do is we will save the firmware, the latest firmware, to the SD card. So just before we dive into the desktop, let's verify the firmware that I'm running on the ColdCard. And what I'm going to do is this never touches the internet. So we're going to plug this in, we're going to power it up, and I'll sign in. I hope you can see that. Okay, so again, ColdCard never touching the internet. It's just powered by the USB power block. So I'm going to enter my PIN off camera, and then I'm going to come back in. All right, so I'm going to bring this in. Hopefully it is focused. It's just starting up. All right, so we want to get into the advanced tools. So scroll down, advanced tools, enter into advanced tools. And we are going to go to upgrade firmware, click into that. And then the first option is show version. I don't know if you can read that, but the first option is show version. And that's what we want to do. We want to see what current version we are on. And we're on 5.2.2. All right, I will jump into the desktop, guys, and I will show you the process of saving the new firmware to the SD card, doing the verification before installing the actual firmware. So we are back in the desktop, and what we want to do first thing is just go back to the top, and we will download the current latest version for the MK4, the 5.3.3, and we're going to save that to the SD card and just keep it as is. Don't rename it. Save. Make sure you're on the SD card. Save that in the SD card. Now the CoinKite have a lot of information here, which I suggest you read to get an understanding of what's actually going on here. But there is a more technical way we can verify the SHA-256 and the signatures. But like I said, with Sparrow Wallet, we have a very nice option to do this quickly. So depending if you're on a Mac or a PC, that will change. But what we do is just click on the go to verification instruction. Okay. And then I'm on a Mac. So to confirm the hash, what you want to do is first of all, just open up the signature TXT and save that file. So just go to the top, file, save page as. Now you want to save this to the SD card. Make sure you're in the SD card and just click signature.txt and hit save. Okay. And then just use the back button, go back to what we were looking at. So next thing you want to do is scroll down a little bit more and you want to save the public key to the same place. So we're going to click on the public key and don't change anything, save it back into the SD card. So you should have three files sitting in the SD card. You should have the, first of all, the binary file, which is the firmware version. And then you got the ASC file, and then you got the manifest signature file. Okay. So now we can open up Sparrow and verify this. Let's go to Sparrow, guys. Sparrow, if you are not familiar with Sparrow, I have links. I'll leave them in the show notes below, how to set up Sparrow wallets. It's a fantastic tool. Very, very useful. The best Bitcoin desktop wallet available. So in Sparrow, just go to the top, go to Tools and Verify Download. Click Verify Download and we'll open up this interface. And now we're going to select, the first file we're going to select is with the extension ASC. So we're going to browse and we're going to browse the SD card and select the file with the extension ASC, open that. And the second one we're going to do is we're going to select the signature TXT and click into that. And Sparrow does the rest. It runs the code and it confirms that the firmware is signed by Peter D. Gray, who is one of the founders of CoinKite, and that hash manifest matches. And it is ready to install. So this software is good to go. It is legitimate from CoinKite and it is safe but effective. So now we have done the verification and we can safely upgrade this firmware into our cold card. And I'll show you again how to do that now in the overhead. All right, so let's just eject that SD card and whoops. Get rid of this guy. Don't need him anymore. All right, so I'm gonna set up my cold card. We're gonna plug her in and we will install the firmware. So let's power up. I'm just gonna enter my code off camera. It's always good practice to reassociate yourself with your cold card every couple of months because you know, get a little rusty. All right, so let's get back into our cold card. I hope this is visible and sharp. Okay, so first thing we want to do is we're going to take our SD card reader. I believe it's this way. Gold teeth out. Is that true? Okay, so we're going to plug this in. All right, so now what we do, guys, is we go back into advanced tools. Okay, we say yes. And now we're going to go down to firmware upgrade, just like we did before. But now we're going to select the upgrade from the micro SD card. So we go to micro SD card and we're going to enter into that. And it's going to say, pick firmware image to use. There is only one. Scroll down, read this. There is only one. So we're going to say yes. And it tells us that it has the date, so it's the file that we've just verified. It's good to go. We're going to click yes. Okay, so that's loading. Install firmware. Tells you what it's installing. 5.3.3 with the date it came out. binary checksum and signature will be further verified before any changes are made. And we've done the verification, we're good to go. So we're gonna click into that. I hope you guys can see this. All right, so go. So now what it's gonna do is it's gonna verify. We have the green light on as it verifies the actual file. And then it will go red when it starts to reinstall. Okay. So, just gonna go off camera. All right, and loading. Starting up, ready to proceed. Okay, so now what we're gonna do is gonna go in back and see what we are running now, what firmware we're running. And go back into upgrade firmware and show version. And we're running 5.3.3. All right, so there it is, guys. Very easy when you know how, but the Sparrow tool, the verify tool, is really very simple, and it's a great way to do the checksum and the show sum and the verification of the signatures, making sure that that firmware is 100%, do we say, kosher. All right, so I hope that helps, guys. Just I can't stress it enough, it's very important to make sure you verify any software for Bitcoin before installing, and give this a read on the CoinKite website to get a better understanding of what you're actually doing. But the Sparrow tool is fantastic. It's a really great and useful way to do what we've just done if you don't have the technical background to do it. I'll have a lot more content coming. I know that the fees are low and everyone's stressing because of the price action. But I think we'll do a how to consolidate UTXOs next. Give us a like, subscribe, kids, and we'll catch you in the next one.